Filipino farmers express confidence they can meet the country's rice demand if government implements the right interventions. Farmers issued a statement following a recent United States report that the Philippines will soon replace China as the world's top rice importer. At least one farmers group says, given the proper aid, the country can become a rice exporter.
Kayang-kaya po. Kasi ang sabi mismo ng gobyerno, mahigit 4 milyong hektarya ang tinatam na ng palay. Itingin nga namin, mula sa 80 cabans, average yield per hectare, pag naging 100, at tingin namin kayang-kaya, hindi lang food self-sufficiency, pwede ngang sa hinaharap, mga 2 to 3 years, posibleng makakapag-export tayo.
The Agriculture Department has since disputed the U.S. report, saying the projections were off the mark. The Marcos administration has also initiated several interventions to ensure stable rice supply. The Philippine Bureau of Customs seizes more than 42,000 bags of rice amounting to 40 million pesos in a warehouse raid in Zamboanga City. Now, the Customs Bureau in the port of Zamboanga says it initially received a tip about the alleged smuggled rice in May. They later carried out an inspection. After receiving information, a big volume of rice arrived through the port without an import entry. Authorities say they found that the listed items and the documents did not match. The BOC is now moving to forfeit the goods in favor of the government. Business groups band together to oppose the proposed 150 peso legislative wage hike. They claim that can eventually lead to price increases and do more harm than good to consumers. Jackie Pascual tells us more.
Many business groups are opposing the proposed legislated 150 pesos minimum wage hike, saying it will negatively affect the economy. The Employers Confederation of the Philippines says many small businesses are still recovering from the pandemic and may not be able to afford the salary increase. The Federation of Filipino-Chinese Chambers of Commerce and Industry agrees, saying the wage hike will likely increase prices of goods and services, or worse, lead to closure of businesses.
Tataas nila yung presyo nila kung kaya pa ng merkado, or magbabawas ng tao para makasunod sila. Kung hindi pwede yung dalawa na yun, magsasara na lang.
Pag yung costing tumaas, ipapasa namin sa produkto namin ang ipapasa namin sa presyo. Kaya sinong mahihirapan eventually? Yung namimili, yung people who are buying our products.
The Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry is worried the proposal may also turn away foreign investors, especially because the Philippines already has high power rates.
Labor costs, it is one of the key input in whether we are competitive or not. Itong increase nito will price ourselves out of competitiveness.
Exchange rate. From a low of 53, 54, now it's 56, going to 57. Additional cost sa amin yan. Electricity, additional cost. Wala kaming control dyan. It's the government, it's outside forces who will determine which one is to increase and which one is not to increase. Ang within our control is labor cost.
Even the Philippine Amalgamated Supermarkets Association is not happy with the proposal, explaining that the recent 40 pesos a day increase was already a bit of a burden for its members.
For a store which has 50 employees, itong recent increase of 40 pesos per day, okay,
yes,
we will need to sell another 100 or 150,000 additional just to, yes, cover the 40 pesos per day for the 50 employees. So if we have 300 employees now for the bigger stores,
yes,
you can imagine how much more we have to sell, and you don't just expect people to buy that much, no, all of a sudden.
The business groups want to have a dialogue with lawmakers on the issue. ECOP says it prefers tripartite wage board consultations to determine wage increases instead of a legislated adjustment. Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri earlier said he is determined to push for the wage hike through legislation, with many Filipinos affected by rising prices of basic goods. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
Moving on, a Philippine lawmaker representing overseas Filipino workers calls for tougher policies in the country's labor agreements with Middle East nations. The proposal was made by Congresswoman Marisa Magsino after the conviction of a Kuwaiti minor over the murder of Filipino worker Julebi Ranara in the Gulf State. Magsino slammed the weak implementation of labor agreements, adding that the Philippine government must ensure recent working conditions for Filipinos abroad.
We have to strengthen our bilateral agreements that we had 4 years ago with Kuwait and other Middle East countries. Mm-hmm. And to be able to do that, we have to have a really stiffer and strict and serious contract agreement with them. We have to make sure that all their living and working conditions are respected. And we have to make sure that the government-to-government policy have to have this very good implementation, because we have the bilateral agreements, but I don't think it's really implemented to A to Z. Mm-hmm. Why? Because I think we are about soft on this.
The Philippine government vows to seek a possible extension of the jail term of Julebi Ranara's killer. This after the family of slain OFW expressed disappointment over the 15-year prison term slapped on the teenage son of Ranara's employer.
Naipaliwanag ko sa pamilya na sa kaso ng Salarin, minor de edad siya. Kaya't merong pag-apply dito ng juvenile criminal law ng Kuwait. Aalamin natin sa ating abogado kung ano pa nga yung legal options.
We need to get in touch with our legal representative in Kuwait para mabigyan tayo ng proper guidance as to what we can do. Ang magagarantihan naman natin, ang maganda rito, nakita nyo naman na hindi tayo nang iwan, hindi tayo bumitaw. Magmula nung pumutok itong bigat na trahedya na ito, nandito pa rin ang pamahalaan para sila ay alalayan.
The Foreign Affairs Department has said challenging the ruling might take time.
Ang problema pag umapela. Pag umapela yan, kasama yan yung damages. So, baka tumagal pa. Pero ang punto, hindi na absurdo.
Ranara's charred body was found in a Kuwaiti desert back in January. An autopsy report showed she was pregnant at the time of her death. Her murder sparked calls to halt the deployment of Filipino migrant workers to Kuwait and a review of the labor agreement between the two countries.